Hello, I'm Robin Whalley, welcome to Lenscraft. The other day, an email came in letting me know there was a new release of the Nik Collection. Today, I'm going to demonstrate the new film simulations in the Nik Collection 2.5 and then show you how you can modify them. I'm starting with my image open in Photoshop, although you can use any application that supports editing with Nik. I'll then launch Nik Color Efex Pro using the Nik Selective tool. You can also launch the Nik plugins from the Photoshop Filters menu. It doesn't make any difference. Now that I have the image in Color Efex Pro, I'm going to add a filter from the Filters library. The filter you want is the Film Efex Modern Branded. If I switch to the split screen mode, you can see the effect of the filter using the default settings. Now look at the top of the filter and you'll see a drop-down list. This lists all the film simulations in the filter, including the 5 new ones in Nik 2.5. If I move down the list with my mouse, you can see a preview of the simulation on the main image. For this image, I'll use the new Fuji FP100C option. I can then use the brightness and contrast sliders to lighten the image and increase the contrast. But when I lighten the image, it also seems to reduce the contrast. And if I increase the contrast, it seems to block up shadow areas. One way to control this is with the shadows and highlights slider. You can use these sliders to protect either the shadows or highlights from adjustments, and this helps you manage any problems with clipping. Another way to control the problem is using control points. If I add a negative control point to the dark area of the sea, I can remove the effect of the filter from that area. You may also find though that the effect's removed from other areas where you want it to appear, and you can add it back in using the plus control point. Now these tools are fine, but there is a third way to control the effect and it's often overlooked. You can adjust the actual film simulation using the Film Details section of the filter. If I expand this, you'll see four sections: Sensitivity, Saturation, Tone Curve and Film Grain. I'll start with the Tone Curve, where I can see that it's applying a lot of contrast to the image, and that's what's causing the problem with the shadows in this image. By adjusting the shadow points on the curve, I can prevent the shadows from becoming blocked up. Now let's look at the sensitivity sliders. These control how light or dark a colour appears in the image. You'll see this when I move the yellow slider left and right. When I move it to the left, it darkens the yellows in the image, and if I move it to the right, it lightens them. By working through each of the sliders and then moving them left to right, you can find out how the image responds. If you want to reset the slider, you can select the film simulation again from the drop-down. Do remember though that this will reset all the film adjustments and that it's not just the sliders. You may find a better approach is to use the history panel. Once you understand how the image responds to the sensitivity sliders, you can tweak them. After that, you can move on to adjust the levels of saturation of individual colours. Again, moving the slider to the left reduces the saturation for a colour, whilst moving it to the right increases it. Finally, I'm going to add a fine soft grain to the image. Once I'm happy with my adjustments, I'll save this as a new recipe. Then I can apply that recipe to any of my images in the future. Now let's compare my modified settings with the original film simulation. I'll start by resetting the filter by selecting the film simulation again. I'll then move the history point slider down to the end of the history list. This sets the latest filter as the before state for any comparisons. I can then apply my saved film recipe to the image to replace the existing film adjustment. If you look in the history list, you can see the new recipes applied. If I change to the split screen view again, you can see the effect. The initial simulation appears on the left, and my modified version appears on the right. And to compare the new simulation with the original image, just return the pointer to the start of the history list. I hope you found today's video useful and that it's given you some new ideas about working with the Nik Collection and the Color Efex film filter. I'm Robin Whalley, you've been watching Lenscraft, I'll see you next time for another video.